Hello and welcome to a stadium that has a wonderfully old-fashioned feel to it, Goodison Park. I'm Derek Ray and delighted to have Stuart Robson sharing commentary duties with me. And very much looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League. It's Everton facing Brighton and Hove Albion.
Thanks, Derek, as always. This should be a good game. Great atmosphere inside the stadium. We've got two teams full of quality, some interesting matchups, and two coaches that want to play an attractive brand of football. What more could you ask for?
And so the battle commences. And a look at the lineup for Brighton. Lewis Dunk plays with Shane Duffy in central defence. And it's an interesting looking attacking constellation with three forwards.
Oh, big chance here, Derek.
And that's sound goalkeeping. Taken short. The defender doing his job. And it took a touch on the way through. So a corner here. And there's the delivery. Oh, good work by the keeper.
Now.
Well, behind for another corner.
Saved by fucking Pickford. Oh. Come on, Evan.
So it's going to be a goal kick here. Well, great news for Newcastle fans. The transfer has gone through. It is now official, Stuart.
Well, I think it's a good move for him. He has great ability, but needs to be that little bit more consistent. I'd say it's a fair price as well.
Everton moving the ball forward with purpose. A wonderful intervention. The news coming through that the referee has pointed to the spot in one of the other matches. With the details, here's Alex.
Awarded the penalty. I don't know what he was thinking with that one. Shot way over the bar. It remains 0-0 with 12 minutes on the clock.
Alex with the in. And that's fantastic goalkeeping to get across and deal with the danger. And with play having stopped, a chance for the referee to go back and hand out the caution.
That was a bad tackle, right?
Now sending it in. Still not clear.
Wonderful ball, isn't it?
And in the end, no damage done. Undav. And Nesiri. Nice looking pass.
Oh,
well, pass after pass. Maybe they can chisel an opportunity. It's a good looking ball in behind. Mitrovic. And the ball is loose. Throw-in coming up for Everton.
Well, they might be piling on the pressure, but they've got to make it count in those situations, that's for sure.
Really surprised.
And on the front foot again, no let-up from them at all.
Aye, aye.
Effective challenge.
Referee. Fucking hell.
Billy Gilmore. Oh, terrific
it's a good ball in. Oh, no.
He saved it well.
Oh. Oh, nice and
Niels and Nkunku. Oh. Regained possession. Now, what can they do from here? And a crucial intervention inside the box. Mope. Gbama on to Mope. Mitrovic takes aim. A superb chance, but he's failed the test.
Well, you can see what he was trying to do, but he's missed the target. He should score there.
Dunk. And the referee has added on 2 minutes of stoppage time. There goes the halftime whistle, and chances. Everton find themselves on level terms at the break. Interested to... And so the second half gets underway. Almost a case of the two teams saying to each other, whatever you can do, I can do just as well. Can he find the right pass? Well, it came to nothing in the end. High pressing at its best. Gives it a go.
Oh,
and it's in! 1-0, they breached the defence.
Last couple of games. Stan Miles here.
Well, here's the replay, and he's got to clear his lines there. He doesn't do that. He has his pocket picked, and he's been rightly punished. Poor defending.
Goal for 1-0 then.
Number 20, Neil Morpay.
Vieira. And a chance to whip it in here.
Oh,
well,
man,
goal kick, just as it was looking promising. Well, just to point you in the right direction, we have more live action from the Premier League coming up here on EA TV. It's Brighton and Hove Albion facing Crystal Palace. Well, we have more knockout football coming up for you. Action from the FA Cup.
Oh, big chance here, Derek.
Oh,
no hiding from the fact that they really should have extended their lead.
Mate,
well, that was a poor miss.
Them.
Could they come to regret that?
Time for a change then. And a change to the scoreline in the Wolves game, I'm hearing. Let's get the news from Alex.
It's a third goal for Spurs. They've pulled one back with 63 minutes played.
Alex with the info as ever.
Kevin, I want that
Morgan Gibbs White.
Get it.
Slip short passing.
Oh, shot.
Richard.
Oh, no!
Oh, a moment of pure class! Had to catch it perfectly, and didn't he just?
Well, as you can see, that's a great bit of skill. He times this so sweetly. What a good goal that is.
What a great header, then. Great finish. Oh, Pickford.
So in business once more, on the back of that very important equaliser. 1-1. 20 minutes remaining. Morgan Gibbs-White. And there to intervene.
Chip all in by my...
Well, let's join Alex Scott now, because I'm hearing, Alex, the situation has changed in the Wolves game.
Come on, Evan.
For Wolverhampton Wanderers, they now...
Could be!
Oh, he's
and a goal!
Dumbly.
Just like that, they're back in front!
Unbelievable goal.
Well, here's the replay. He's got such quick feet, hasn't he? Just look how he goes past his marker to get his shot away. That's a really good goal.
Brilliant finishing game. Didn't look great season. Amazing. Yeah. Go on, I can come on. White isn't going to play in the next game anyway. I want to save them. I'm taking them off. I know we can go with his attack, but I think he needs the rest. I think 10 minutes to go, 2-0. Why is that train thing come on? Weird. Like a bug. Bug in the game.
Dramatic moment near the end, and that might well be the decider. 10 minutes to go. The right place to cut out the pass. And news of a goal at Molineux. Who has scored it? Alex has the answer for us.
Yeah, it's a goal for Spurs. They've pulled one back and now trail by one. With just under 10 minutes to go.
Cheers, Alex. And just making the run a bit too early. Offside as a result. And time for the change now. And the referee has deemed that an additional 4 minutes are in order. Teammates in the middle. And a struggle to get it away properly.
Played wide. Get away. Have they done enough, Everton?
Well, nothing comes of it.
Oh. Go on, old God.
And here they come, still pressing for an equaliser. This could be the equaliser.
Oh, great. Defending.
So the referee blows for full time, and it's an Everton success story, whatever way you look at it. 3 points for the Toffees. What did you think of their performance?
Well, Derek, it was a tight game. Both sides had their moments and chances, but overall, they just about shaded it. A well-earned victory.
And there's the delivery. Oh, good work by the keeper. Well, behind for another corner.
Pickford outstanding again.
Could be. And that's That's fantastic goalkeeping to get across and deal with the danger. Takes aim. High pressing at its best. Gives it a go.
Just got his eye on him, looks like. Got his eye in. Everything he touches seems to be golden.
No hiding from the fact that they really should have extended. Slipshod passing. Could be. And a goal! Just like that, they're back in front.
Just a couple of questions for you.
Yeah, they have a stunning performance. A great win and a great win. Kept a good team as well. Big win.
Thank you for your time.
Our camera lens trained on one man. Will he add to his total of four goals from his last three? This is EA TV. Hello and welcome wherever you're watching. This is Goodison Park. I'm Derek Ray, and with me here on the commentary box is Stuart Robson. And we've got Premier League action coming right up. It's Everton, and they face Brentford.
Well, Derek, we can talk about coaches and their methods, but it's now down to the players. Which ones are going to stand out, who will affect the game, and who will have the greater desire? It should be a cracking game, though.
And the game begins. And here's how Everton line up. Well, with tackling like that, the onus is on the referee to take action, potentially. So we have an early booking here to report, Stuart.
Yeah, and I think the referee's absolutely right. He's just making it clear to all the players out there he's not going to take any messing about here.
He did not go there.
Tarkovsky. Kappa. Well, he dealt with that ball played in rather well. Me. Well, for Everton, an unpleasant experience last time out when they lost against Liverpool. What do you expect to see this time, Stuart?
Well, it was a game they could have won, but the 3-2 scoreline shows just how easy they are to play against. Today, I'm expecting them to battle hard, defend well all over the pitch, and get a result here.
Well, it's tight at the top and extremely tense, just as we would want it, Stuart.
Well, it looks like being a very close race for the title, doesn't it? There's nothing to choose between the teams, but can one of them just go on a great run and pull away?
Well, I'm hearing there's been a goal at Selhurst Park, but who has scored it? Alex is going to tell us.
It's a goal from Palace. They've scored the opener here with 50 minutes played.
Alex keeping us right up to date.
Nice play.
Mykolenko. And Kramaric on the ball. Can he find the right pass? Well, didn't go to plan in the end. Mykolenko. Mope. Perfect tackle. Ivan Toney. Mikael Damsgaard. Still on level terms, moving the ball nicely. Well, just the kind of save every goalkeeper would expect to make. Pedro Neto. Jeremy Doku.
Doku did well.
Well, as you can see, Everton have had most of the ball, but they haven't done enough with it, particularly in the midfield areas, where their passing has been far too safe. And that needs to change quickly if they're to win this one.
Can they forge ahead from this corner kick? Let's see. Playing it in.
Oh!
And the keeper did magnificently.
Well, that's just a wonderful save. How did he stop that?
Mope. Well, a textbook interception. Dominguez.
Oh, no.
Mbeumo. The high press was very much on. It's there for him! Well, decent save there. And over comes the corner. And so there we have it. The first half has come to an end here at Goodison. And as the second half commences, both sides can reflect on a first half in which they weren't so very evenly matched. Referees are rightly praised for giving advantage, but when there is no advantage, it has to be a free kick. And yellow it is. A booking?
Yeah, he was too impatient to win the ball and probably deserved a yellow card.
He's given it straight to the opposition.
Come on, eh?
Toney. Vitaly Janert. Good movement. And the ball in the net at Selhurst Park. That news coming through. Alex Scott.
It's a second goal for Crystal Palace. They're back in this now with 53 minutes played.
Alex with the info as ever. Well, the outcome is a free kick here. Man.
Kicking us
well,
off,
no
eh?
Card, but the referee making it clear next time there will be one shown. Well, you have to conclude, Stuart, an opportunity wasted.
Yeah, and the other players are furious with him, and rightly so. That's such a poor free kick.
Kicking at us, making him get a free kick straight away.
Possession lost, intercepted. Well, he really is danger personified, but in this game, Stuart, what do you think we might see from him?
Well, the stats tell you everything. He's a top-class striker. Even when he's having a quiet game, he can still pop up with a goal, as we may well see today.
Great having the pass football.
Andrej Kramaric. And winning it back.
Changes might be needed here.
Can they create something from here? Could have been awkward for the goalkeeper. Well, a poor effort from a difficult angle, Stuart. Yeah.
Well, he took the wrong decision there. He surely had to cut that back.
Would the owner Kappa. Of the red car obstructing the main entrance please remove the car as soon as possible? Thank you.
Oh, delightful pass.
Comfortable in dealing with the ball played in. Mbeumo. Ivan Toney. And he takes it away. The referee correctly decided to play advantage.
That's it. Come on. 77 minutes.
Over the touchline for what will be an Everton throw. Well, the referee letting them continue, but now it's going to be a booking.
Well, he tried to play the advantage, but he was always going to come back to that challenge.
And a substitution in the offing. Tarkowski. Plenty of support here. Well, they're certainly thinking about a winner. Really good high press. And breaking developments at Selhurst Park. Here's Alex Scott with the information.
Yeah, it's a third goal for Crystal Palace. They now lead 3-2 with 83 minutes on the clock.
Alex keeping us right up to date. The referee spotted the infringement and it will be a free kick in a position of genuine menace. And they're making a change.
Jesus Christ.
Substitution for Everton. Coming off the pitch, number 9, Pedro Neto. Coming onto the pitch, number 7, Dwight McNeil.
What?
At this stage of the game, it might be decisive. And just look at their supporters.
Oh, God. Absolute nightmare. Fucking hell, Pickford. Come on, try to punch in.
Well, here it is again. First to the ball, clever header and a good finish. He's done really well there.
Oh, he beat him to the ball. Oh, biggest mistake Pickford's done. Oh, what? Jesus. Keep it going. come on.
What a big moment in the dying embers. Will it prove decisive here? Well, time is against them. They have work to do. Defensive roadblock in the way of that cross.
A terrible game for them, really.
Dominguez.
Oh, come on.
And we saw the situation developing.
Oh,
so the referee blows the whistle, and that is the end of the contest, and it goes down officially as a defeat for Everton.
Yes, Derek, it was a tight game between two very good sides, but they lost concentration late on, and it's cost them dearly. They'll need to get over that quickly.
His performance in this particular game will have impressed many people, Stuart.
Well, he's the match winner, and deservedly so. He was outstanding today. He's great to watch when he's in this sort of form.